What's up, guys? Drone worship in your face. So I just watched this video on this insanely good autonomous drone that just hit the market. I mean, this thing is ridiculous, just ridiculous. I actually made some notes here after I did a little bit of research. We're going to kind of go into my thoughts. This thing is called the Skydio R1. This thing was made by some former MIT graduate students, and from my understanding, this thing is ridiculous with its autonomy technologists. It's autonomous technology that it has built into it. I mean, this is probably the most advanced autonomous drone on the market to date right now. This thing is supposed to be ridiculous. It has 13 onboard cameras that like tell it real-time crazy information. Like, this thing apparently is supposed to be like uncrashable, just ridiculousness. I watched a few videos of it, man, and this thing traverses terrain. It's just incredible. If you guys have not watched a video on this thing, look up the Skydio R1. I'm going to put a picture over here so you guys can check that out here. I'll leave that picture up here for a while we talk about this. This thing shoots in 4K. Apparently, it does have stabilized footage. And apparently for its navigational system, it actually uses the cameras instead of the GPS because it allows it to make faster decisions. That seems crazy to me that they've been able to perfect that technology that good. I mean, guys, when you watch this thing function, it is ridiculous to watch it go through trees, underneath branches. Like, this thing can follow you at a very quick pace. This is like a sports drone designed for like snowboarders, dirt bikers, BMX people, skateboarding. This drone is for the people that are in the sports world, doing outdoor activities, stuff like that. This drone is not so much for like real estate footage, stuff like that. This is what I would consider an action drone. Okay, and I think there were a couple attempts at this a while ago, like the Iris. I forget some of the other ones, but there were definitely a few attempts at this type of autonomy with drone flying, and nobody was able to gauge it in this fashion. This is ridiculous how good this thing is. The onboard computer system of this thing is just ridiculous. I cannot say that enough, guys. After watching, I probably watched 20 videos on this thing, and it is just amazing how good the autonomous features are on this. Now remember, this thing is expensive, guys. It does have its downfalls. We'll talk about some of those. One of those being, it is $2,500 for a drone that basically has one function, follow you. But apparently it does it so good that they really didn't feel like it needed other features. So this is what I would consider an action drone. That is the purpose of this, is an activities action drone. It is for you people that are out doing crazy, crazy activities where you would need a drone to follow you without a pilot. I mean, this thing just is redonkulous. No joke. I know I keep saying that. I'm not kidding. Look at some videos on this thing. It has a bunch of different tracking modes. I don't really know what those are yet because they're not really releasing too much information on what the tracking modes are. It does run on your phone. It runs on Android and iOS. There is no transmitter that I'm currently aware of for this unit. So it's basically like maybe a 200-foot range, whatever your phone capability is for as far as following you and how it should follow you. So that's kind of a drawback. The other drawback is it's only got a 16-minute battery. That's kind of, I mean, in the world of drones today, you got drones that fly for 20, 25, 29, almost 30 minutes. 16 minutes really is not that much. But, I mean, it is what it is. It's new to the market. I'm sure they'll release upgrade batteries at some point for this thing. But as of right now, most people probably aren't going to be able to afford this at $2,500 price point. Some people will. I can't wait to start seeing some videos on this thing. But the other side of this is that it only has a 64-gigabyte internal memory that is not expandable. Now, this is all beta production stuff, so I'm sure later on we may actually see, you know, an extended expandable bay for memory, but apparently as of right now, it only has 64 gigabytes of internal memory that is not expandable at this current time frame. The other thing that apparently I found out is that it can't understand water. The sensors don't understand water, so if it was to go over water, apparently it would crash. That's unfortunate that they weren't able to figure that out yet, but once again, this is still kind of like a beta bird. You know, they're still testing, but from what I have seen, this thing is just shooting under low branches, finding gaps in trees like that. I mean, its ability to navigate is just crazy good. It is just the most insane autonomous flight I have seen yet from a drone by itself. Okay, making its own decisions and calculating its own information. It is just ridiculous how well they have managed to knock this out. So at a $2,500 price point, I'd say that's a little far-fetched at the moment. Most people probably won't be able to afford that, but it's out there. It's on the market now. DJI, look out, because this thing is ridiculous. So that is my current thoughts right now. If you're looking for an action drone that's going to follow you and do those kind of things, this drone may be the future of autonomous flight. I kid you not. The way this thing traversed through the course, through the trees, through everything they put it through, man, I was just wowed. I was floored when I first saw the video. So anyways, guys, that is my first initial thoughts of the Skydio R1. If you guys have not looked into this thing, definitely look into it, because it is going to make quite an impact, I think, in the drone world and the future of drones if this technology is able to be harnessed and released to all the rest of the companies, especially like DJI. If DJI got their hands on this kind of technology for autonomous flight, look out, man. Active track is good, but it's nowhere near as good as what these guys have done. I mean, it is just ridiculous. Kind of like I feel like at the Bebop. I've never seen stabilization as good as the Bebop, but the French won't release that kind of information and that technology to the world. So it'll be interesting to see what these MIT tech guys come up with next and what their plans are for the Skydio R1 drone. All right, guys, that's my first initial thoughts on this thing. Drone Worship, and I'm out. Toodaroo.